Supreme Court handed down two rulings about what kind of violent offenders can be locked up indefinitely. Well, here now, NBC's justice correspondent Pete Williams joins us. And Pete, I want to start with this ruling on sex offenders, because you sit there and you look at it on paper, so they can serve their term. They've been sentenced.
Right.
And now another government official, you know what? We don't want to release them.
Well, it's civil.
Said okay.
It's civil commitment. The key to this is understanding that this is inmates who are mentally ill and deemed sexually dangerous. And so the question for the court is, did Congress have the power to pass a law that said that they could?
So this was a federal state issue.
It was a federal constitutional challenge. This is a federal law. The Supreme Court has already upheld the power of the states to do this.
Okay.
Did so several years ago. So this is a question about a federal law. And, you know, the same theory would apply to the states as well, the same constitutional theory. The dissenters, Thomas and Scalia, said that the fact that the federal government has the authority to imprison somebody for the purpose of punishing him for a federal crime, whether it's related to sex or something else, doesn't give the government the additional power to exercise indefinite civil control over that person. That's the issue. What Justice Breyer, who wrote the majority opinion, said is, suppose you had someone who had a communicable disease that they caught while they were in prison, tuberculosis. Doesn't the government have the ability to say, well, no, we're not going to just release that person into the public. We're going to keep them somewhere and make sure they get over their tuberculosis. The same theory, he said, should apply here. The point is, you put these people in a hospital, and when they're deemed well enough, no longer mentally ill, then they can be released.
And the person that made this argument, particularly the quarantine argument, was
Justice Breyer.
Well, but also who argued this case in front of the Supreme Court.
Oh.
Was Solicitor General and now Supreme Court nominee Elena Kagan.
Defending the federal law, but that's her job.
And was there anything about what she did that, you know, may have helped the majority? Anything about this decision that somehow helps her?
I don't think so. I think this was garden variety Solicitor General's job to defend a federal statute.
All right, very quickly, the other decision.
The other decision, the Supreme Court said that you cannot give life without parole sentences to juveniles if they commit some crime less than murder. This changes the law in 37 states. The Supreme Court said basically it's disproportionate to the crime. It's cruel and unusual punishment under the Eighth Amendment.
And what was the split on this one?
5-4 on that.
Five to four.
The usual split.
The usual split. Yep. All right. Pete Williams, our justice correspondent.